Bruce Springsteen's Born in the USA tour ends in Los Angeles next week. At one stop along the tour, 6'4" saxophonist Clarence Clemons, the big man, as Springsteen calls him, talked with Dixie Whatley.
Clarence Clemons first met Bruce Springsteen one rainy night back in the early 70s when both were playing small clubs in New Jersey. A mutual friend suggested that Clemons go hear Springsteen sing.
Very few people know this. I remember this. Well, people that are there remember. When I opened the door, the wind blew the door right down the street. I mean, it's totally like this guy walks over and tears the door off this building and walks in and says, I want to play, you know. So what's he going to do? Say no, you know. So anyway, I walked in there, and that's when the magic started.
What is it that has made you stay together for as long as you have?
It's the respect that we have for each other, the respect we have for Bruce, and the love we have for each other, you know. There is real love there, you know, and real respect. Bruce is a genius.
In line with their mutual respect, the boss helped polish the video from Clemons' first solo album 2 years ago. The big man is now working on his latest solo project, juggling studio sessions around the current Springsteen tour. It'll be his debut as a lead singer.
It's going to surprise a lot of people, you know. The name of the album is Hero, and it'll be out in January, I think.
A picture-toting father, Clemons likes to practice his singing with his son, Christopher.
I do my vocal lessons, you know, I hold him in my arms, and he sings along with me. He's 6 months old, and he sings along with me now, you know, and he loves it, you know.
The big man has also found time to toot his own horn in Aretha Franklin's new hit video.
Think that as your solo career takes off, you'll ever leave the E Street Band?
No. Because there's a bond between Bruce and I that I don't think will ever be broken. You know, he's my friend, and I'm his friend. And being with him affords me the time to do my own thing. You know, every man wants to leave his own footprints in the sand of time.